Have you ever wondered about what animals get up to when we're not looking? Would you believe some are keeping busy with the latest tech? I'm off to the zoo to find out how a group of white-faced Saki monkeys are using a special box that plays videos. The research team created the box as a way to enrich the lives of these small primates by giving them the choice of how and when to use the device.
I'm here with Ileana Hirsky-Douglas, computer scientist interested in animal technology. Why is it that you set out to do this particular project?
So we were very much interested in how we can give animals control over their environment and especially how they can control technology. Typically, when we use technology with animals, we usually use it on them, so we play them sounds rather than giving them the option of choosing whether to listen to or controlling the technology themselves. So it's really important for us that technology gives animals a choice whether to use it or not to use it, and also that we build technology in a way that's friendly for animals.
Vilma Kankampää is a master's student in computer science who's been part of this project. What did the monkeys do with the video device?
Yeah, we got interesting results. First of all, we learned that they do pay attention to the screen. They do like watch it, they are even tactile and...
Okay, so they're really engaged with it.
Yeah. We learned that the monkeys actually recognize objects on the screen, because one of the videos we show was presenting them worms, the kind of mealworms that they are fed. So they actually tried to leak the worms out of the screen and they went even around the tunnel to see if the worms are behind it.
Oh, wow.
Additionally, we saw that the device might affect the monkey's behavior. So we learned that the scratching behavior decreased during the time of the study, which can be a very positive sign.
Even though enrichment systems for zoo animals have been around for a while, very few give animals direct control over when and what they do. The Sakis control this device by stepping into the box to see the video of the week. From life under the sea, to wiggly worms, to other zoo animals, to lush forest scenes, and some abstract images too. The video device is actually a souped-up version of what the research team initially developed. A mini on-demand jukebox of sorts that plays sounds for the Sakis.
So we looked at like various different audios. We tried to get stuff that was on different frequency spectrums. We looked at rain sounds. We looked at electronic music, traffic sounds, zen calming music, for instance, and also no sound at all to see how it would affect.
And what were the results of your study?
So they used the device a lot more when they played traffic sounds, actually.
Traffic sounds? And was that unexpected? That sounds a bit funny to me.
Working with animals, you have to sort of keep an open mind to what you expect. But it was unexpected because this isn't a sound we suspect they haven't heard before. And this was very heavy traffic sounds, actually from a busy Indian street. So a lot of beeping, a lot of shouting, things like this.
Kirsi Pyynönen has been part of the project on behalf of Korkeasaari Zoo. What use can technology be for animals?
We are using technology in order to enrich the environment of these monkeys. Traditionally, very often we use food as enrichment. We hide food. In here we have seen nice parcels where the monkeys can dig out treats. But of course we don't want to use all the time food for enrichment. It would be very nice to have other things. Until now we have been always thinking about that the big apes are reacting on screens and doing things with that kind of enrichment, but we never really expected that monkeys, who are maybe not that clever as apes are, would also do the same. So we are now very curious, waiting if we can use this in the future as well.
So in the future, will I be able to call my dog on Zoom, or could Saki monkeys like these call each other from zoo to zoo on different sides of the planet?
I hope so. I think the wonderful benefit that the internet and technology has brought to us is something really wonderful to offer to animals. In the future, I hope we can explore more devices and more systems for animals that can really help them have more control over their lives and also open up into different areas.